Hello, good morning dear students. Hope so you all are fine. Yes, as in the last video, I have told you about the topics which we have done from this chapter. So let's start today's topic. This is chemistry class plus one. Today's date is 26th April and the unit name is Some Basic Concept of Chemistry. So today I'm going to start this new topic, that is Law of Chemical Combination. Okay, Law of Chemical Combination. So what is chemical combination? This we need to understand first. So dear student, as you know that the matter we have done in this chapter, matter is all the substance which occupy space and have mass is called matter, and matter is the basic study of atoms. Okay, basically matter is made up of atom. The basic constituent particle of matter is atom. It means that whatever things is there in our surrounding, whatever material you will see in our surrounding, that is basically made up of any atom, and chemistry is the study of subject atom. Okay, so atom or combination of atom, by combining atom we can get daily new substances. So this chemistry of combination is basically known as law of chemical combination. So basically what happened in 17th century, some of the scientists, they were trying to establish the base of these chemical combination, and ultimately they came out with five different ways. Okay, these are the five different ways: first, second, third, fourth and fifth, in which law of conservation of mass, law of definite proportion or constant composition, law of multiple proportion, law of reciprocal proportion and Gay-Lussac law of combined gas volume. Okay, so these are the five basic law. These five basic law we will discuss one by one. So let's start with the law of chemical combination, which is having five different laws. So in exam it can come in single topic also, it can come separately also. So okay, so first let's discuss law of conservation of mass. Law of conservation of mass, it is given by Antoine Lavoisier. Already you have done in 10th class that balancing in chemical equation. The balancing in chemical equation is under this law of conservation mass, in which we have discussed that the number of reactant side, the element reacting in number of reactant side is equal to the number of product side. Okay, so in all the physical changes, so what is the meaning of law of conservation? In all the physical changes and chemical changes, whether there is physical change or chemical change, the total mass, this is very important, the total mass of the product is same as the total mass of the reactant. Okay, so what is the meaning? Total mass of the product is same as the total mass of the reactant. It can be written in this way also: mass can neither be created nor be destroyed in a chemical reaction. So if it is neither created nor destroyed, it is called indestructible. Indestructible means it is not breaking, so it is also called indestructible of matter. Because of that it is also called indestructible matter. Okay, so basically in this form, one example I will take you. First recognize the face of Antoine Lavoisier. He gave the law of conservation of mass. So there is one question is like this way: when 4.2 gram this is going to be observed, so what is happening? The chemical equation, this and this will combine, this is reactant, and form this and this and this, this is product. So we will see basically this and this, the weight of this and this is this much, and the weight of this is this much. Okay, so now we will see the weight of these two reactant is 14.2 gram, and the weight of these also 14.2 gram. It means that the mass of reactant is equal to the mass of product. So hence there is no change in mass, so the chemical reaction is it is following the law of conservation of mass. Okay, so like this way. Next is law of definite proportion or constant composition, which is given by Joseph Prost in 1799. According to this law, a pure chemical compound always consists of same element combined together in a fixed proportion by weight. So this you need to see: fixed proportion by weight. One is to the total mass is equal to the total mass of reactant is equal to total mass of product. In this case, particularly a fixed proportion by weight. Okay, suppose for example we will take an example in burning of coke in air. when carbon is burning in air, तो one carbon is reacting here, two oxygen is reacting here. तो total one carbon, two oxygen. This is balancing. But if this side carbon and oxygen is there, the product side also carbon and oxygen will be there only. That is the meaning of definite proportion. And these will combine in the form of proportion. Okay. So basically, see the face of Joseph Prost. He gave the law of definite proportion, and according to him, what he did. So it deal with the composition of various element present in the compound. He also worked in the field of sugar and carbohydrate, and he showed that the sugar in grapes is the same as sugar in honey. So sugar in grapes is same as the sugar in honey. This kind of example in our daily life is going following the law of definite proportion. Like this way, third is law of multiple proportion. Multiple word is multiple mean many. Okay, so John Dalton has given this in 1803. So according to this law, if two element combine to form two or more compounds, if two element combine to form two or more compound, like we have a nitrogen and oxygen, two element, they are forming so many molecule, N2O, NO, N2O2, N2O4, N2O5, clear? And the weight of one of the element, mean weight of any one of the element, which combine with the fixed weight of the other, in this compound, they bear a simple whole number ratio, as we will see in this formula, in this table. So oxides of nitrogen, these are the oxide of nitrogen which we discussed. So you can see, as you know, that the molecular mass, it is very important. So number of part of the weight of nitrogen. Nitrogen is N2 in 28, 14 is the mass, 42 is 28. Here single nitrogen is there, 14. Here two nitrogen is 28, two nitrogen 28, two nitrogen 20. Like this way, oxygen, here single oxygen 16, single oxygen 16. If three oxygen is there, 16, 3 is 48. 4 oxygen is there, 64 is 64. 5 oxygen is there, 80. Okay. Now we will see 14 part of nitrogen as fixed weight. Mean the mass of nitrogen is basically 14, and the oxygen is single. If there is two number, like atomic number, if 7 is the single nitrogen, if nitrogen have 7 electron, so 2 nitrogen have 14. Single oxygen have 8. Like this way. So with these two ratio, we will get 8, 16, 24, 32, 40. 8, 16, 24, 32, 40. Now when we will make it common, so we will see 8 table is following. 8, 1 is 8, 8, 2 is 16, 8, 3 is 24, 8, 4 is 32, 8, 5 is 40. It means that the simplest ratio become 1 ratio, 2 ratio, 3 ratio, 4 ratio, 5. It means that this is following multiple proportion. Two element to form two or more compound and form a whole number ratio is called multiple proportion. Similar way, next law is law of reciprocal proportion. Reciprocal, opposite. It is given by Richter. The relationship between the masses of the element when more than two such element combine between themselves. Let's understand with the definition. The ratio, it is the ratio in which two element combine separately. First, the ratio of two element combined separately. Suppose here carbon is combining with oxygen separately, forming carbon dioxide. Then oxygen combined with hydrogen, forming HO2. But common carbon is making bond with hydrogen and oxygen, to forming CH4, Ca2. So like this way, if any of the two element, carbon and hydrogen is there, and one oxygen is there. When so CH4 is carbon H. O, C and H2. So you can understand carbon has 12 mass, hydrogen is 4. So it becomes 4 upon 12, hydrogen upon carbon, giving 4 upon 12 ratio. Like this way, carbon dioxide is oxygen 32, carbon 12, so 32 upon 12. When we will combine these two, when we will divide these two, we are getting this ratio. This is the solution ratio, 1 ratio 8. Similar way, when these two common is separately combined, H2O, so H2O is 2 upon 16, it is also getting 1 upon 8. Now 1 upon 8 divided 1 upon 8 becoming simplest ratio. This simplest ratio is called reciprocal ratio. It means that the ratio of this divided ratio of these two is giving us 1 ratio 1. then this kind of ratio is coming, that is called reciprocal proportion. Next is Gay-Lussac law of combined volume. Last Gay-Lussac law of combined volume, obviously Gay-Lussac has given in 1808. According to him, under similar condition of temperature and pressure, condition is giving similar condition of temperature and pressure, whenever gas is combined, any two gases combined, they do so in volume and they wear simplest whole number ratio with the gases product. Suppose hydrogen gas combined with chlorine gas, hydrogen and chlorine gas combined, they will form HCl gas. Okay, it is gas, suppose HCl gas. Now see the ratio, hydrogen is having one volume, chlorine also one volume, one and one volume will give two volume of HCl. The ratio become 1:1:2. It means that it is also giving a similar ratio. So when the two gases combine, their product will also be gas, and the two gases which is combining, that will be also the ratio of the combined product gas. So this is all about the law of chemical combination. Revision, quick revision. There are 5 laws of chemical combination which combinedly form a law of chemical combination. These 5 laws will make a law of chemical combination. So basically, all these scientists, they have given us these 5 laws to make this. So hope so you understood. That's it for today. For your better understand, I am sharing one more video to you. Please keep on noting down these. Rest, stay safe, stay home, and take care. Thank you. Have a nice day.